first things first, make sure to wash your face well before applying your makeup for the day. It is a must. I'm using my Spin for Perfect Skin brush along with my Cetaphil. After my face is washed, I move on to my Bliss Triple Oxygen Vitamin C Day Cream. I use this day and night. It makes my skin brighter, more rejuvenated. I absolutely love how it feels, nice and light and a little bit moisturizing. After I have my cream on, I move on to my Bliss Baggage Handler, just another eye gel, eye cream, whatever you like. It is awesome for preventing dry under eye, and that's why I need it in my life. Now I'm moving on to moisturizer. Please use a moisturizer. It is so important. I love the Olay Complete. I use the sensitive one because it has a broad spectrum SPF, and I use a shit ton because I want my skin feeling moisturized and protected for the day. Yes. If you have super dry skin, I highly recommend a Hydro Milk. I'm not going to use it, but if you have dry skin, give it a whirl. Now moving on to the Nivea Post Shave Balm. I just started using this as a primer, and it is hands down one of the best primers I've ever used in my life. It makes your skin nice and sticky, as you can see, ready for makeup. Not icky sticky either. Don't worry about that. Now I'm moving on to my foundation, and you can either choose to apply it with a beauty blender or a brush. That is a preference up to you. I highly recommend the beauty blender, the beauty blender, a damp one. You just tap it into your foundation and then you bounce it all over your skin, really blending that foundation out. It's super easy application, and that's why I recommend it for beginners, because it really pushes the product into your skin, giving an airbrushed, flawless finish. You can see the difference between my left side of my face and the right. The foundation just makes the skin that much more glowy and even. I love it. So just bounce that damp beauty blender all over your skin. Make sure to get your ears so they match your face and neck, bouncing until you have the coverage that you desire. Moving on to any sort of concealer that you like, but I love the NYX HD Concealer in the color beige because it's not too light. Making little triangles underneath my eyes and then bringing that concealer up right underneath my eye. This is going to help you really brighten and lift the under eye area once you blend it out. I also love applying a tiny bit to the chin and forehead so you can blend that center of the face up and down, creating more of a brightness coming from the center. Again, using the same damp beauty blender and just bouncing it on the concealer, blending it away. If you feel more comfortable using your finger, go ahead, press that product in. Don't forget to get the area right next to your tear duct, since that's usually the darkest area. And on my other eye, I'm going to be using my Micro Beauty Blender. But don't fret if you don't have either one of those. Well, I hope you have a finger. Just go back to your big beauty blender and use whatever you have left from the under eyes to just brighten and conceal the center of your face. After you are nice and concealed, you gotta lock it in for the day. So one of my favorites is the Laura Mercier Secret Brightening Powder. It's a loose powder. I love loose powders for locking in concealers. I'm first starting off with my Micro Beauty Blender, or you can use a sponge as well. And again, bouncing it on top of that concealer. We're not moving the concealer, we're just locking it in for the day using that powder. Now on the other side, if you're more comfortable using a brush, I'm using my Real Techniques powder brush, tapping off the excess of the powder, and then again, bouncing it on top of the concealer so we are not moving or smudging that concealer. We want that perfect finish underneath the eyes, so no creasing. Now, if you are a little more on the oily side, go ahead and take a big fluffy brush and just lightly tap any sort of powder that you like. I'm using my Physician's Formula Mineral Powder, where you get most oily. That for me is on my forehead and actually underneath my cheekbones. So I just lightly powder those sides of my face.
Woo!
After my eyes are done, I still need to finish my face. I have not contoured or bronzed yet, and I highly recommend the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit just because it comes already with three great matte bronze and contouring colors, and it's super easy to choose from. Now, make a fishy face to find where your cheekbone is so you can get right underneath there. And go ahead and lightly make little circular strokes underneath your cheekbones to get a little bit of a shadow and hollowness to them. So you can contour, you can see the difference again from the left side to the right side. Do the same thing underneath the other cheekbone, and then to the temples and forehead, I like to just lightly pat the bronzer on. So again, we're not moving anything we've already put there. Temples, forehead, underneath the chin and jawline, just to get a little bit of definition. I do my nose so quick and light because I just like a soft contoured finish. Now, if you're using blush, I love NYX blushes, and you're just going to lightly apply from the apples of your cheeks and blend upwards. You do not need that much. You just want a flush of color. And finally, if you like that dewy finish like I do, take any sort of highlight that you like, and I love this highlighting brush. It's from BH Cosmetics. And go ahead and apply your highlight on top of what you applied your blush and contour on, so on top of your cheekbones, and a bit down the center of the face. I love doing the tip of my nose, the middle of my nose, on top of my Cupid's bow, and a little bit on my chin, just to really brighten up my face. After you are highlighted, go ahead and finish the rest of your makeup, lips, lashes, whatever you have, and then set your makeup for the day. My favorite setting spray is the Urban Decay All Nighter. Your makeup will not move. Spray as much or as little as you want. You are good to go for the day. Your foundation will not move. You look glowy. You look soft and contoured, and you did an awesome job.